So, hello and welcome to day 2 of the IC. We're currently 6-3 with the Sorgaleo team. And let's see, I'm not sure how many matches I will record today. Depends on how it goes and how much time I have. Let's see, we play with Hamza. Solid rating. And another Kyogre. Like, why did I build a team that beats down Venusaur stuff when I don't face a single Groudon Venusaur or Zacian Vinocool team? That's really annoying. At least this team doesn't have Ferrothorn, however Urshifu Kyogre is pretty troublesome on its own. What do we lead? Could lead Porygon. Porygon Thunderous is an option. I mean, they probably have Taunt. But if they Taunt, then they at least cannot go for like a max, kind of max Kyogre and Tailwind. We go Tapu Fini. You know what we could also do? Could do... No, I don't like this too much. I think we will try to bench Sorgaleo. Because I want to Dynamax the Thunderous. Okay, Taunt Ogre. So basically my opponent has... I should get pranks there right now. Which is pretty good. Of course I get Drizzle. Pranks would have been amazing. What's the switch into Mixed Lightning? Probably... Katana. Like, he could go... Switch Kyogre out, Taunt. I think I will... Do I go Airstream Foul Play? I feel like he has to switch or Taunt. Like, I don't think he can just... Tailwind Water Sport, honestly. And if he does, then this gets pretty annoying. I can't see him doing that. Maybe he goes for Protect Taunt, and then followed up by Water Sport Tailwind next turn. That could be an option. Wow, he just was... He just goes for the Tailwind? Man... I don't get those people. That's not good. It's also a shame that I didn't trace the prankster. Because now you can just bring Katana, Max Air, some Water Sport, and I'll probably just lose. I just... Man, what would I do if I just Max Lightning, Trick Room? Like, they would be screwed completely. I don't get why people make plays like this. Like, do they disrespect Porygon that much? I mean, now they will just go Airstream Porygon Water Sport, right? And there's nothing I can really do about that. Like, as soon as I lose Incin, I lose to Katana anyways. They probably have Urshifu on the back. I will sack Fini. Maybe they target Polygon and I somehow live the water spout. I don't know why they do that much damage. Normally I'm weak that water spout, even with Mystic Water, shouldn't KO my Thunderous. Like, without Dynamax, so it should be a 3 KO in Dynamax. So I don't know why it deals so much damage. Because Specs should do more. I'm just a little bit mad, like... All of these Torn Ogres players just don't respect my Tailwind, and I don't know why. Like, if they Tailwind and I just Trick Room, what do they do? Especially if I just nuke the Ogre, like if I go Max Lightning Trick Room. They stuck in Tailwind and lost Kyogre for nothing. Do we live? We don't, okay, then we can forfeit. I just don't know why it did that much damage. Like, I should live modest Mystic Water Water Spot in rain with my Thunderous without Dynamax. So, is he timid choice specs? Like, that's the only explanation I have. I'm really getting pissed by that. Like, facing 6 Kyogres in 10 matches, something like this, when Zacian and stuff is everywhere, that's really annoying. Like, I counter build versus Zacian Vinocool stuff, because while practicing, I've played literally 0 Kyogres and like a bajillion Sun teams. And now I think I face Groudon once and Zacian also once, but not Zacian Vinocool, which is... Why? I don't get it. And also these these Kyogre Tornadus teams wouldn't be that tough if they just would properly respect my Tailwind and my Trick Room. Okay, here we go. Groudon stuff. I think Garchomp looks pretty decent here. Like, I think my game plan was Garchomp Incin. Tapu Fini, Zeuger, Leoroid. I think that was my game plan. If they lead Groudon... Grimmsnarl, that could be bad. Groudon Grimmsnarl could be very bad. I mean, I get intimidated off. I probably can parting shot the Groudon. Shouldn't be too bad, honestly. Umbreon Grimmsnarl. I mean, that's really passive. Unfortunately, I can't really Sword Sense here. Because of the foul play option. I could still Sword Sense, but that would be very, very greedy. And I think they target Garchomp anyways. What I could do is switch into Tapu Fini. And parting shot the Grimmsnarl. Just make sure that they can't really snarl next turn. There's the foreplay. Yeah, don't into Garchomp. Seems like he goes for play or spirit break, I mean. Okay, good play. Covered for the Phoenix Switch. However, I get Solgaleo in right now. Which is not too bad for me. The question is, do I want to Dynamax Solgaleo right away? I mean, honestly, he can't really afford to foreplay me. Because if I Dynamax and get the Steel Spike boost, and he foreplays me, does zero damage. So, I honestly... But if he foreplays regardless, I'm a little bit screwed, I guess. But honestly, I don't see him doing that. What else would he do? Could also protect his scout, but I think I want to Sunstrike the Grimmsnarl. Does he really go for the foul play? Can't believe that. I could have just this bike. This was probably a little bit greedy on my end. I can't see him doing anything else in foul play if he stays in. He moonlights. Okay, that's something. Basically, we got a free core mind. I just don't want to Dynamax Solgaleo right away because he could have Charizard in the back. Charizard in the back would be very troublesome right now. I want to scout a bit. Like, does he go for foreplay now? That's my question. Cause if he doesn't have Charizard in the back, he can't really threaten Solgaleo for too much damage. Foreplays. So honestly, I think he has Charizard in the back. Because otherwise I don't see how he beats down Solgaleo. Like Groudon for sure. Then Charizard or Venusaur, I would guess. I think I Moonblast the Grimmsnarl for the KO. I don't want to Dynamax Solgaleo because of the potential Charizard. This could be a very big misplay. Okay, that's good. Now I proc my policy and I still have my Dynamax. However, Misty Turn is slowly running out. I have to keep that in mind. I think I have one more turn of Misty Turn. Or does he bring in Groudon? There's a Charizard. That's what I have been waiting for the whole time. Obviously can just go for switching out into Groudon, nuking Solgaleo. I think I'm Moonblast, Rock Slide. It also protect Moonblast. But honestly, if he Dynamax Charizard, like if he Dynamax Charizard, Garchomp is pretty good. As I said, I could also choose to not Dynamax and just nuke my Solgaleo. Which would also be a good play on his end. But he Dynamaxes, and the thing is, if he chooses to max Wildfire, he doesn't get an Airstream boost. And then Garchomp outspeeds him. And if he goes for max Airstream, I will do massive damage with plus 2 Rock Slide. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Next turn I will... What do I do? Switch Fini out into Incin for the Intimidate onto Groudon and max Rock for the Charizard, right? I mean, he has Reflector, but I don't think he's living that regardless. And Groudon shouldn't do too much damage to Garchomp. I just have to keep in mind that Groudon can set up Sword Stance, which... like, he could go for max Guard Sword Stance, which I think is the most likely play for him. However, like, I can't let Charizard go Rampage here. And I really want to get Intimidate off and reset the terrain as well. Like, I have to max Rock for the Charizard. Even though I think he will max Guard. If he max Airstreams, I'm screwed. Some Charizards are a Assault Vest. We didn't see a Life Orb. So I would just go for Max Rockfall. It doesn't switch. Sword Stance would be annoying right now. However, as I said, there is not much I can do about it anyways. However, beating down Groudon behind the Reflect will be a challenge. I could also opted for Sword Stance, but yeah, he just doesn't max guard, so I made the right play. Oh, he lives! Reflect coming in big. That's not ideal. That's really not ideal. Yeah, that's the Sword Stance. What's my play here? Safety effects. Most likely protects Groudon here because of the fake out. I will go into Fini. Rockfall for the Charizard KO. I can't see him attacking with Groudon. Like, he could, because I won't do too much damage to him anyways. Charizard Turret that survived in a rockfall was really not good for me. I didn't think it would survive even with the reflect. Oh, it just double attacks. That's not good. I take way too much damage now. Oh, that's big. However, it's still gonna be tough. Beat him down. Especially since the Skrull most likely has a Citrus Berry. And it also beats everything, and the Sand Chip plus Wildfire Chip really starts to become annoying. If we KO Charizard, like, this is where Life Orb would be a better item on Garchomp. I was thinking about Life Orb or Wild Herb, and I dropped Life Orb. God. Because, like, Intimidate and Scary Face was really annoying. I need to beat down the Groudon. How many turns of Reflect are left? Two. I have to target Groudon, right? I don't think I can beat down Groudon anymore because of the speed boost. Did it outspeed my Garchomp? I didn't pay attention. I don't think it did. Did it? Did. Okay, that's super bad. I do absolutely zero damage. Very well played by my opponent. What could I have done better? Honestly, I don't know. Maybe just setting Feeny up with the Steel Spikes and Coal Mines. Maybe that was even the play. But then he still has Charizard in the sun, and Feeny doesn't do much. I think then Charizard just destroys my whole team. I'm not really sure what would have been a better play. I'm just a little bit angry that now I don't have... Life Orb. Wildfire is over, right? Yeah. I mean, he doesn't have to fear the Fake God at all. I don't think he will protect, but that's my only out. He does protect, okay. What's my out? I like, because there's one more turn of light screen, I won't even KO the Umbreon right now. Fake out Muddy Water most likely. Hope for the accuracy drop on Groudon. That's basically my only play. I mean, Finny. Finny survived the precipice. Then maybe. I mean, it's spread. My Finny is super bulky. How much did I calculate? Plus one. No, I don't. I only calc neutral. Think. I mean, doesn't matter regardless. I have to go for the muddy water. Moonblast. I don't. Maybe Moonblast will also be enough. Think so. I mean, do we KO? I didn't want to risk the mist, but we're minus one. Okay, we do KO him. What's the optimal play right now? I keep moonblasting. I think I call mine for now, because he won't do any damage regardless. And if he moonlights, then moonblast is better. I think I will moonblast at the very end. Obviously, I'm sorry for that, but I didn't have another out anyways, so I had to go for that. Oh, here's Jorn. I should have moonblasted. Jorn, foul play. Snarl moonlight, but he doesn't have protect. So I will moonblast right now. I think we lose because he can just heal himself. Was the comment greedy? I don't know. The comment was really that greedy. Do we lose if we are both at full HP? I think we do because my team should have more HP overall. Please wake up, Finny. Please. If we wake up, we should just win. Please wake up. I think we will lose if the timer goes to zero, because we're both at full HP, but I should have more HP, like my team should have more HP in total, in numbers. So, but Finny has lower HP than Umbreon, right? Basically this means that he has more, yeah, he has more HP on the total. That's annoying. Damn it. Man, the team was so consistent while practicing. Takes 5. I'm gonna keep playing. Like, no, not such a low rated opponent, that's really ass. What's that? Honestly, your team is pretty scary. I will hit Tapu Fini because of the sleep stuff. think the Puffini Polygon is pretty solid here. Just to play. What if you just lead Senti Scorch? I mean, Senti Scorch is really bad, I guess, if I just lead Guard Chomp or Thunderous. But he could lead Senti Scorch Feeny, I guess. Senti Scorch Dragapult, I meant. Cover for those options. Honestly, the team is pretty scary. Cause Senti Scorch also has Coil. Okay, that's fine. I think that should be fine. What's my play? Switching into... I could have competitive. I mean, normally people don't run competitive, but what's normal? But I mean, you can't say anything is normal versus Bolthound, I guess. I don't want to switch an instant, I'm gonna be honest. Like, if he has competitive and I switch an instant, that's really fucking bad. But Feeny is so good against this team. I mean, he doesn't target into Porygon, I guess. Oh, not foreplay. I'm gonna Trick Room. Trick Room switch. If he doubles Porygon and I activate competitive, I could be a little screwed. But I don't think he doubles into Porygon. He's not competitive. Okay, that's good. And Butterfree can't hex me because of the terrain. Honestly, it's solid damage. What do I do now? Parting Shot the Bolthound. And Impulse the Butterfree. But also Flare Bits Butterfree. But I think keeping Instant for later is beneficial. And with both being minus 2, they should do too much damage on the Solgaleo switch anyways. Yeah, I like that. Like, keeping Incineroar for later can be pretty decent. The question is, what do I do next? I think I max crack the Bolthound. Max crack for play the Bolthound slot. I say I don't even have to max crack. I kinda have, because Earthquake would hit my one Porygon. I mean, it wouldn't do too much damage anyways. Yeah, I think I can just Earthquake your Impulse. I don't want to waste turns of Max. I don't really have to. Okay, pretty good. Start out his max. Stay 2 turns of trick room. What's the play here? Instant already took some decent damage. I think I will Rockfall because of potential focus sash. Did get the intimidate on the board. Could always switch Infini, but if he calls it, Infini takes too much damage and I don't want it to happen. Obviously could go for Steel Spike, but I don't know the item on the Butterfree. Like, it's not Life Orb, and normally it's Life Orb, Focus Sash or Scarf. So it could still be Focus Sash. I don't want to waste 2 turns of max for Butterfree. And I want to get rid of Butterfree because of potential Rage Powder in the late game. Yeah, there's the Rage Powder. That's why I went for Rockfall. Drain Punch I don't think will KO. Okay, that's big. Cause now Buzzwole was stuck at minus one. Let's see what's the last one. Maybe Dracofish? Could see it being Dracofish. Lanzorin is Dragapult. Then I will just dispatch Dragapult and Punish Shot you. I could switch into Fini directly to cover for Protect, but I really like the Parting Shot option, making Buzzwole completely useless. What does he go for? I mean, it doesn't matter. That's a Dragapult. I will just... Is he in range of another turn of sand? Yeah, so we'll just max guard Moonblast. Buzzwole. Also my Fini is faster than the Buzzwole. Which means Zergelia is also faster. I mean, we take those wins. Okay, yeah, that's it for this episode. Pretty bad episode overall, two losses. And now this guy. It's gonna be a tough run. But I still think it's possible to qualify. Okay, see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching and yeah, goodbye.